Dance of the Planets. Welcome to Stargazers. I'm Dean Regas, astronomer from the Cincinnati Observatory.
And I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Plot Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida. Dean, would you say I'm fond of conjunctions?
Fond is too subtle. Conjunction obsessed would be more appropriate.
Exactly. So, at the end of this week, we'll get to see the culmination of an amazing week-long rendezvous between Mercury and Venus. And then, a little over a month later, we'll see a super scoochie between Venus, the red planet Mars, and a two-day-old waxing crescent moon.
So, join us as we go planet watching. Let's show you. Okay, we have our skies set for immediately after sunset on Sunday, January 11th, facing west. You'll notice two bright lights next to each other in the dwindling twilight. The brighter of the two is our sister planet, Venus.
The smaller and fainter of the two is the planet closest to the Sun, the planet Mercury. If you watch these two planets this week and next, as the days pass, they will get closer and closer to each other, reaching their closest appearance to each other on Saturday evening, January 10th, and they'll be moving away from each other on Sunday, January 11th.
You're probably asking yourself, why do the planets appear to move every night against the background stars?
That's a good question, because it really puzzled our ancestors. For most of human history, there was no scientific explanation for what the stars were. So, many cultures considered the stars as being divine. The motion of the stars through the sky was so predictable that people could actually tell time based on the position of the stars.
There were a few peculiar lights that seemed to move among the stars, appearing in a different position each night. And not only would they move, but they would change their direction, their speed, their brightness, and even their color. These lights would even disappear for a while and then reappear.
The strange behavior of these lights prompted many ancient cultures to believe that these wandering stars were greater gods than the fixed stars, and their bizarre motions were messages from the gods expressing their pleasure or displeasure with the doings of man.
Ancient Greek astronomers referred to these wandering stars as asteres planetes, which we have shortened today to planet. We now define a planet as being a relatively large spherical body that orbits a star, in our case, the Sun. Given the godly history of the planets, each of the major planets is named after a character in Roman mythology.
For example, Mercury is named after the messenger of the Roman gods. He was known for his speed, and this planet lives up to its namesake. Mercury is traveling over 100,000 miles per hour around the Sun and can complete one orbit in about 88 days. Earth completes one orbit in a little over 365 days.
Venus, the brightest and the most dazzling of the naked eye planets, was named after the Roman goddess of beauty. However, its beauty is deceptive. Venus has one of the most hostile planetary environments we know. Its atmosphere is poisonous to us, and its surface temperature is hot enough to melt lead.
So, let's watch how these planets move. Go outside at sunset this week and next, and shortly after the Sun disappears, you'll see Mercury and Venus snuggling up to each other. Here they are early this week on January 5th, the 6th, the 7th, the 8th, the 9th, and they get super close on January 10th, and then on Sunday, January 11th, Mercury starts moving away from Venus.
Now, watch how Venus and Mercury behave next week. Here they are again, right after sunset on Sunday, January 11th. Now the 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, and finally January 18th. As you can see, Mercury is pretty speedy.
But wait, there's more. Let's fast forward through time and watch Venus as the weeks pass. As each week goes by, watch Venus as it gets higher and higher, and then by Friday, February 20th, you're in for a treat. Venus and the red planet Mars have a super scoochie.
And they'll be joined by a two-day-old waxing crescent moon.
So, get outside and watch the dance of the planets.
It's easy to do when you
keep looking up.